Blog Talk Radio.
Peace to the ancestors. Yes. Peace to Dr. Cornell West. Yes. Peace to the movement. Yes. We came from the bottom. Ever since they got us, we've been going through these problems. 400 years behind, and it's no promise that we gon' never actually be equal, to be honest. It's messed up how they put us in chains, kidnapped our language and changed our names. But when we speak Ebonics, then they call it a shame. They leave us with a couple options, rob or slang. Now we locked up a game. How much can our skin take? We went from slaves to inmates, carrying the weight of the 50 states. Working your forms, black nannies carrying white babies in their arms. Black men sacrifice their lives in your wars, but you'll never show appreciation here at home. You treat us so damn wrong. You act like you hate my race. The police, they just beat us in the streets like an 808 base. America, when will you defend my case? You never will, cause your freedom is fake. I'm only living here cause I wanna get paid enough to round up all my family and shake.
Get up, get up.
Couple of quirks, can't call it pancakes, cause you pour some syrup. It's a whole lot bigger than a pretty new house, especially when the rodent's still running about. P. Diddy running marathons, races go. That's going to the school where the tax money go. Homeland Security, now there's a phenomenon. Pacifying folks by hanging Saddam. Troops still riding, still obliging, still no Bin Laden. Tuned in, waiting for the president's announcements. No 40 acres. Take these 40 ounces. We ain't gonna get on the levees. Revolution televised early. Is you ready?
Why you wanna treat me so cold, America?
Forced to climb and shit and have your back, have you beat and lost your mind, especially when you done been down for so much time. Getting up don't even really ever cross your mind. You got pawn shop, gun shop, liquor store time, SWAT team, crack fiends, unemployed line, stay late, dollar short, trying to buy time. What we do to survive is defined as a life of crime. You can't ball, then you forced to grind. If you fall, then you forced the line. And I've been putting in work from 9 to 5 and 5 to 9. Since phone calls cost a dime, what it made me is one of the relevant, highly intelligent. Brothers not only dealing with that same drug selling. If I'm a hustler, then what's more American? We all founded on the same drug
America,
heritage.
Why you wanna treat me so cold, America?
Tonight's topic, the LiveWaves App. Dr. Lee and Dr. Cannon started this initiative about 3 years ago to provide a forum for us to discuss the contemporary topics of our day. Dr. Lee is the founder of the Neighborhood Commerce Institute, which is a national organization dedicated to grant writing services for those in need. Dr. Cannon is the father of entertainer Nick Cannon, the president of the Nick Cannon Foundation, and the visionary behind 400 years of African American History Institute. Dr. Lee and Dr. Cannon, along with Trace McMullen, a recent graduate with a communications degree who brings his technical expertise and visionary prowess to the show to offer a fresh perspective, along with the team of doctors, have come together to put this show together for us to have a place to communicate. Recently, and this is just a personal note from me, the show has become a featured event, and I'd like to offer a congratulations to Dr. Lee, Dr. Cannon, Trace McMullen, Dr. Anita Moncrief, Dr. Curtis Longs, and Dr. Tynes for their dutiful dedication to the show, which apparently is reaching a broader audience. And also, special thank you to Dr. Gregory Tatum, a man whose shoes that I've been trying to fill, who got called back to government service, but his work, along with the work of everyone else, is the reason why the show has achieved this minor but well-deserved milestone. So congratulations to you all. And now, without further ado, you know her, you love her, Dr. Mary Lee.
Thank you so much, Garrett. I appreciate you. And you're doing a great job. You're doing a great job. We certainly do miss Dr. Tatum, but he is still working with us and behind the scenes. Soon we're going to be doing expanding. We are expanding. And I'm excited, really excited about it. So we'll be on, in addition to this time, we'll be on other times, on other platforms, and he'll be able to join us. And so we're really excited about where we are, what we're doing. We're thankful and grateful. We welcome all of you. We thank you for joining us week after week, and then just supporting and listening throughout the week and sharing our show. It's our show, and we appreciate you all. So tonight we're kind of shifting gears a little bit, but we're still on topic because everything that we talk about really centers around systemic racism and in every capacity, you know, in every profession. And so we are absolutely, you know, working together to bring about needed change. So we're not here just to talk and rant and rave and, you know, to collect money off of YouTube and anybody who would give us money. Like we could literally, you know, have advertisers on the show. I have turned down advertisers. We have turned down advertisers. Now, I ain't going to say we because James, wherever you are, the canon, tonight, I know you're listening. I know you're extremely busy. So when you can get on, hop on. But if it was left up to you, James Cannon, we would have advertisers on here. But that has been a personal choice of mine, because I want us to be able to carry on our conversations, to talk, and, you know, when we get there financially, we're all going to get there together. And so this is the aim. We want this platform to be one that you can come on, you can share, you can pour your heart out, you can cry, you can laugh, and you can fight. But we don't fight for it to laugh. We don't deal with animosity, but yes, we're going to disagree, but we need to disagree so that we can find a meeting point somewhere, a space where we can grow together in spite of our differences. And so I thank you all for being here. I do see some of the doctors on, and you know I appreciate you so much, all of you. So we're going to get going tonight. But I think I think what we'll do is we'll review, and we're going to ask Dr. Long and Dr. Moncrief, starting with Dr. Moncrief, to come on and kind of review where we've been and where we're going. Everything and everyone fits in all together. Now, just for the record, let's see. Michael Dorsey is one of our special guests, and I know that you're on. If you can reach out, I think maybe our Dominique may be having problems getting on. I just we don't see him just yet, so if you could kind of send a text message or reach out, and we can, unless he's in on a different phone number, we need to know that too. So we're going to ask Dr. Moncrief to introduce yourself, say who you are, and just kind of summarize what we do here. Thank you, Dr. Moncrief.
Good evening, and thank you, Dr. Mary Lee, for having me on the show, and thank you to all the guests and to the audience for tuning in and allowing me to share some of my thoughts and perspectives. Over the past few weeks, we've been talking about systemic racism from the perspective of what's happening in medicine. We were focusing on the history of medicine dating back to the first documented textbooks and medical schools in the world, which were in Africa, and we had Dr. James Brown did a brilliant summary of that component of the history. And then we came here to the United States and we talked about the history of the black medical schools and departments here in the United States. And while I did not have enough time really to talk about, and it's a possibility to talk about it, even if I had 2 whole hours, the different black medical schools, we did have a chance to enter into some of the history, why they opened and why they closed, and then we had an opportunity to talk about what we can do in the future. And I introduced the concept to you of reparations in terms of opening black medical schools and reopening black hospitals here in the United States, and the reason why it's important that we do that, and the reason why it's important that we, when we do that, that we have adequate funding, not just for a few years, but for decades. And we talked about the impact of the Flexner report, which came out in 1910, and how it closed 5 of the 7 black hospitals, black medical schools that were open at that time, and how it was really a racist report, and how if you really look behind the scenes of the Flexner report, you can see the built-in racism. You can see the intent to close medical schools that were not allopathic, including all the black medical schools. And, you know, just like we like to limit resources. Well, when resources are limited, we give those resources to the most affluent areas. When Flexner closed 5 of the 7 black medical schools, he left only 2 open, Howard and Meharry, and that was mainly to keep diseases that he called infectious diseases, contagion, black community. You needed somebody to be trained to address that. So we talked about the intent. We talked about the importance of having the critical race theory taught in our schools and in our educational system so that we can understand why things happen the way they did. They did not happen by accident, and why we have to, as we look for solutions, we have to be intentional about our solutions and not just hope that somebody's going to come in and give you a solution. So, I think that's my summary of what has been happening over the past few weeks. Very excited that we're flipping, going to another component, which we're stepping out of medicine. But as Dr. Lee said, you know, systemic racism goes through every single system that we have in this country, And it's only when we open our eyes and we can see it, you know, don't stay in denial. Don't be an ostrich and stick your head in the ground like it doesn't exist. It's only when you open your eyes and you can actually see it, then you can address it honestly, and then you can address it intentionally, and then we can get solutions. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And we would like for our, when your time comes, our guest tonight to your challenges that you have experienced, you know, in your profession when it comes to systemic racism. I want our guest to be certain to dial in. If you do the link, we're not going to be able to, you won't be able to join us. And so you won't be able to speak. You can hear us, but you won't be able to speak. So we need our callers. We need you to call in and tap one on your phone so that your line can be open. We're still missing Mr. Dominique McMullen. So if you would please dial the call-in number, which is 1-845-241-9836. 1-845-241-9836. Please dial in and tap 1. And we're going to ask, okay, so we're going to ask Dr. Longs to introduce yourself and share how you would like to share tonight.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Mary Lee. Again, it's always a pleasure to be on air with such an esteemed, definitely a host in yourself and Dr. Cannon and all of the esteemed partners, Dr. Moncrief, Dr. Tyne, as well as Trey, and, of course, Jared. So I'm Dr. Curtis Longs. I'm a physician who practices psychiatry and behavioral sciences within the Detroit metropolitan area. My primary focus in the latter part of my career is with adolescent youth and their families. And again, you know, when we think about where we started, let's say we go back to March, we were talking about what it takes to save our sons and daughters or our children throughout their lifespan, which, again, has us focusing on the impact of systemic racism within all areas of our life. From there, I'll say I really learned a lot from Dr. Moncrief and her studies and her projects with the various medical schools and how they were destroyed by this Flexner report, and just getting more information about that. The reason I think we all realize this is so important because we deal with the impact of the Flexner report and systemic racism on a daily basis. And as it relates to African Americans and American medical schools and what's happening around the country, which our numbers are steadily drifting downward, how that impacts our ability to treat our population with all the things that are associated with what's happening in the cities, et cetera. And for me, particularly as a behavioral scientist, trying to treat our people, you know, there's some challenges, and rightfully so, related to the amount of distrust, not only in medicine, but particularly in the area of psychiatry. Our discussions are also were associated with our program that we did in June for Juneteenth. So it's important that we continue this talk. I wish other people would tune in on the program because I think it's very important. And I can't think of a day that where our topics aren't implemented in some of the things I try to institute. Just to share with you guys today, a young man that Dr. Time mentored for me maybe a month ago. You know, I try to do whatever's necessary to try to make some inroads, but I had this young man Skype his paternal grandmother who was really praying for him as he's about to go to court, and more than likely he's going to be sent away for 30 plus years. But, you know, today was so significant. I was, you know, sitting there looking at him. I've been engaging him for 4 years, and I said, wow. You know, he finally gets it. You know, he finally gets it. And, you know, it was important because I wonder where he would be, not to say, you know, blow my own horn, but, you know, what it takes to be show a sense of patience for our youth and listen to them, which is always what I'm advocating. And so despite him having, you know, undoubtedly having to go do some time away, I think having more African-American and not only in medicine, particularly in behavioral health, is crucial to create a sense of trust and motivation to make changes in their lives. Because as you guys know, you know, you can see on the news every night, it's an ongoing battle for these youth to try to survive in this whole era of distruth, mistrust, et cetera. So our topics are right on point in terms of the impact of institutionalized racism on all of us in every area of life that we all engage in. So it's been a joy and definitely a learning experience from my perspective too, listening to my colleagues and all the guests that are on the show. So I look forward to, again, learning more by our two guests tonight, Mr. McMullen and Mr. Dorsey. Again, thank you, Dr. Mary Lee.
Thank you so much, Dr. Longs, and we appreciate you. It's very important that regardless as to what topic that we're talking about, and whether the LiveWaves app founders and executives, that particular business, or any other business, the way that racism, systemic racism, has affected us, it has affected our health. And so, you know, in case anyone might be wondering, well, you know, why does she keep the doctors on? I tell you, I keep the doctors on for my own health and psychological and medical, because what we go through in life and things that happen to us, it affects our health either physically or psychologically. I don't care what it is that we're going through and what we're dealing with. And we as a people, we have a problem, and this has been, we've been programmed such, it's been embedded into us, you know, have an issue with our psychiatrists and our psychological doctors, you know, our mental health. You know, we want to feel, oh, we're fine, we're great, we're just, no, we're not. No, we're not. We've been programmed, we've been brainwashed, and we're continually being brainwashed and programmed every single day. We don't understand how systemic racism affects our day-to-day life within our homes, with our loved ones, why we interact or react, why we do the things we do. We have DNA, we have our ancestors that, you know, characteristics and traits, habits that have been trickled down, that have been passed down to us from generation to generation to generation. We are not who we are supposed to be, period. But we're getting there. We are waking up. So this is why we want to surround ourselves with health care. And I encourage everyone to do that. You know, whether I'm sitting across from my psychiatrist in the office or texting, I'm getting help. And so, and while we're talking about health, I want to let thank all of you who said a prayer. You know, I got beautiful flowers, door that is just still got my house just smelling so beautiful and fresh. So I want to thank you all for your love, for sending your love and your prayers, you know, after this, you know, this accident that I had, and which I'm still recovering from, and it probably will be a little bit to get completely well, but I am, my scans were all normal, thank God, but I'm going to be sore and experience certain things along the way. And so, again, I thank you all. So let's introduce, let's get our guests here. Our text say that Mr. Dominique is still not
on.
Who is this?
This is Dominique McMullen.
You are on. You must be on a different line.
Yeah,
okay.
I'm on a different phone line.
Okay, no problem. No problem. Great. Glad you're here. Well, welcome. Thank you. So we are set and ready to go. We're going to Dominique McMullen was born in Big Rapids, Michigan, and moved to Detroit at the age of 6 years old. He is a 37-year-old graduate of Tres Devant. I'm going to ask everyone, please, to unmute your phones while you're not speaking so that we can we don't have the background noise. Thank you. Okay. Graduate of Tres Devant High School in Memphis, Tennessee, before spending 3 years at Detroit City, and was the great honor of having three children and one grandchild. Mr. McMullen attended Tennessee State University, located in Nashville, Tennessee, where he majored in physical therapy. In 2007, Dominique transferred to the University of Phoenix, where he changed his major to business finance. Shortly thereafter, 2008, Dominique started a commercial cleaning service called Executive Clean Cleaning Service. With Executive Clean, Dominique served clients such as P.F. Chang's, Pee Wee's, Buffalo Wild Wings, and J. Alexander's until 2013. In 2017, Dominique pivoted into the world of entertainment, hospitality, and corporate relations as he was appointed as the Director of Public Relations and Corporate Partnerships for a $5 million state-of-the-art nightclub and restaurant called Trust, Cocktails and Shareables, in the heart of downtown, located in the financial district. In this position, Mr. McMullen negotiated contract terms and conditions with several professionals and corporations in the business, political, judicial, entertainment, sports, and private sectors. Furthermore, these contracts were procured to facilitate, function, and host a plethora of high-end events with the likes of the NAACP, NSBE, NFL, NBA, Twitter, Def Jam, Macy's, and iHeartMedia, just to name a few. Currently, Dominique is co-owner and a board member of LiveWaves Inc., which is the brainchild of Wyrd Ventures, a black-owned tech company. Serving as director of business development, he is tasked with building strategic partnerships, garnering corporate sponsorships, and developing new business. His professional work continues as the chief strategist and partner of We On Autopilot LLC, which is a digital marketing, advertising, and business consulting firm in Detroit, Michigan. Mr. McMullen is also, as of August 2021, a regional director of the Franchise Enterprise, a company that assists corporations in franchising statewide, nationwide, and abroad. Dominique is a man of faith that depends on God to bring power and wisdom into his life. As a result, he is currently the arm and bearer for New Zion Fellowship Ministries under the leadership of Pastor C.L. Lyman that has allowed him to do community work and minister to others. Welcome, Dominique McMullen. If you'll just say hello, then we're going to introduce Michael and then give you guys the floor. Dominique.
Hello. Hello. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, we can hear you.
Yes,
thank you.
For
thank you so much. And thank you for joining us. We're excited. Michael Dorsey was born and raised in Detroit, Michigan. He is a 48-year-old, a graduate of Detroit Renaissance High School, and has the privilege of having four children. Mr. Dorsey earned a Bachelor of Science degree from Michigan Technological University, located in Houghton, Michigan. In 1998, Michael started a financial services business as a licensed financial representative that he successfully ran until 2004. In 2004, Michael went to work for National City Bank as a financial consultant. In this position, he helped many families with financial education and investment portfolios. This is also where he began to assist small business with achieving financial goals through the bank's lending options. In 2005, while working at the bank, Michael opened a real estate investing company, CM3 Solutions. For the next 3 years, his company purchased, refurbished, and sold homes in the Metro Detroit area. In 2008, Michael continued to assist small business owners as well as the private sector in finding solutions to their capital needs by establishing relationships with lenders throughout the world. The needs of his clients range from single-family residences to new technology development. In 2018, Michael began helping small business owners realize their dream of becoming a franchisor. He has since advanced to the position of executive vice president of the franchise enterprise. He assists the president and staff with consulting businesses through the franchise development process. Currently, Michael is a partner at Wyrd Ventures and Consulting, Inc., a black-owned tech that he runs with two dynamic men of standard. As the chief operations officer, he is tasked with facilitating company operations, practices, and functions. His company provides cutting-edge technology products and has positioned itself to be a major force in the tech industry. Wyrd has launched a prolific mobile application named LiveWaves. His professional work continues as chairman of the board of directors at Detroit Possible, which is a nonprofit company in Detroit, Michigan. Michael relies heavily on his faith for direction and guidance in all that he does. This allows him to serve his local ministry, the Open Door Church of God in Christ, Detroit, which is under the leadership of Pastor Alan Evans Sr., as an elder, administrator, and youth leader. Wow, I am so excited to get on board with you all. I'm just extremely excited. The floor is yours. Come to us in every way you wish. We want to know more about everything and your live ways, how that is going to revolutionize Dr. Early live show, as well as our constituents and all of the businesses that we work with. Welcome, gentlemen. The floor is now yours.
Well, thank you so much. Go for it.
Well, first of all, I want to thank you, Dr. Mary Lee, for this platform, giving us a chance to, you know, come on here and talk about what we do and how we do it. I want to thank the rest of the doctors that are also here today. So I'm very grateful and excited about this right now.
Great. So, again, I also am honored and humbled for this platform. Thank you so much, Dr. Mary Lee, and all of the great colleagues on this call. Let me tell you something. When I didn't know what to expect upon taking the interview, and once I heard the prelude and all of the pre-talk before we got on, I knew I was in the right place. Our company, Wyrd Ventures Inc., and our affiliate, LiveWaves, we are a company that is black owned and black ran, meaning we have the vision, we have an objective, and we have the scope to make sure that we are creating products and vision and opportunities to level the playing field that we know has been hedged in the benefit from other people for far too long. It is very important for us to understand that if we don't control the narrative, then we're always going to be put in a position to have to rely and depend on other people for information, for opportunity, and for resources. And we purpose as a company, as a brand, and as creatives to help us bridge the gap and hedge it to where now we are also getting access to the same resources, same opportunities, and same levels of success as others have gotten, especially in media and in tech. So just to give a little background, we started this particular venture back in 2014, where we had developed a mobile app. We have a CBO, Andreas Parsley, and we have our CFO, Jason Wright. As the two other founders of this organization, we developed this mobile application called LiveWaves. And that was the first nuance of the app, and it was started to meet a need to where you have individuals that like to party and go to clubs and entertainment in that fashion. So the notion was to create an app that allowed them to see what happens in a particular club or event and decide whether they want to attend or not based upon what's happening. Secondly, also during that time, you had entertainers and performers that were performing in these clubs, and you understand that once the club reached capacity, then they no longer were able to increase their income because the persons weren't coming back in the building. So we decided, hey, why don't we create a situation where artists can now have unlimited income because they can live stream their performances once the building has reached capacity to an audience that's now even outside the city and the state and the country. So we were live streaming performances back in 2014, creating instances where people can see things through their phone, tablet, and computer. But understanding that back then and even now, blacks in tech weren't looked at in the same fashion. And we were discriminated against. We were treated as though we didn't belong. And we weren't given the same opportunities and the resources that others garnered. Hence, we didn't get the traction that we thought. So that project kind of was tabled as we sought to go back to the drawing board. And then something happened in 2019. 2020. A pandemic happened to where now everyone around the world was forced to interact virtually. And hence, now we had a chance to be reborn. So we rebranded Club Tonight into LiveWaves. We added a whole bunch of new dope features that put us ahead of all other platforms that are in existence to where now we created this all-in-one tool that content providers and entertainers and anyone that has video and audio content can use to fully access their following, fully monetize without any type of limitations or hindrances based upon algorithms or ads or any biases, and fully be able to do everything that they need to do to promote and push their intellectual property.
And also to add to that, you know, to give you a visual, imagine taking YouTube, Eventbrite, SoundCloud, OnlyFans, and putting all those platforms in one. And so when you do that, you have LiveWaves. We're a one-stop shop. And some of the features that we have are the Echo Player. So the Echo Player is a sound recording player as to where if you're an artist, whether a singer or a rapper, you have the ability to take your mixtape, your album, your single, and record that mixtape, the album, or that single, and charge, you know, your fan page, your fan base, or your followers, whoever you want. But also in that, you can get paid on something called BDSM. That means broadcast data systems, like radio spins. Also, you have a feature for nonprofits. It's an in-app donate button that we created for nonprofits. So, for example, if you have a foundation or a nonprofit and you're doing a charity event, people who are viewing the event via live stream will be able to donate live to the event on the spot, anywhere in the city, anywhere in the country, or anywhere in the world. Also, we have a pay-per-view feature in the app as to, for the content creator, they'll be able to set a location, a time, a price point, and a date for the event. Furthermore, we also have an in-app ticketing feature like Eventbrite, as to where you'll be able to use pre-sale tickets for your event prior to your event. And so we just talked about four or five different ways that you can create revenue as a content creator.
This is really awesome. To do all of this is to offer community and we, like where we're safe, you know, I always think of safety and you know, at certain levels of this utilizing, you know, the internet and the ability to be able to do this, I think is very important for us as a people to understand and to know that we have, you know, people of your caliber designing and developing platforms such as this, you know, for our use. So, you know, you can continue, and anyone, you know, anyone can just jump in the conversation. So, you know, our doctors and so go ahead.
And so one of the thoughts, Dr. Mary, was to create a platform for people who have content, right? To give you a small example, Dave Chappelle, he had an issue with Comedy Central. He wanted to put his Chappelle show on Netflix. And when he was trying to do that, you know, he didn't own his likeness. He didn't own his content. And he could control his revenue or his content that he did. And so we wanted to create a platform where we gave, you know, the power back in the hands of the actual creator, right? You know, the ones that, you know, that committed blood, sweat, and tears to their work, to their craft, to their art form. So that way, not only will they be able to control, you know, their revenue, but also they'd be able to control and own their content. You know, we need more ownership in tech in media, in entertainment. You know, oftentimes, you know, a lot of people, you know, who go and get, you know, involved in entertainment, sometimes, you know, they get bad deals. And so we wanted to create a platform that can help mitigate or resolve all those problems.
And so basically, what you're saying is that the entertainers, for the most part, do not own their own product, their own material, because of the distributors. Is that what we're saying?
Yeah,
when they contract their music or contract it and then it's distributed, they sell their rights to their own intellectual property.
Yes, ma'am. In some cases, especially like, you know, in earlier times, right? You know, throughout history, you know, the stories, like, you know, a lot of your pioneers, you know, they didn't get paid, but they should have got paid, right? Because they didn't own or control their music, you know, their masters, their content. And so, you know, we're using technology as a vehicle to help, you know, solve that problem. It breaks my heart that, you know, you have, you know, many artists that, you know, put the work in and the effort, the time in, and everyone, you know, who owns that content and controls that content, you know, makes more money and reap the benefits more than the actual artists or the content creators.
Mm-hmm.
And so I know that LiveWaves, you know, will be the platform that's going to solve that issue.
And
Dr.
so
Lee, this
they,
is Jay. Could I ask a question?
Sure.
Hello, guys. How are you? It's great to hear from you. I'm so appreciative of two black men who are working in the tech sector. You are 100% right. We don't have enough representation in tech. It's almost as though it seemed to be mythical when you talk about a black man or black people doing tech. So first off, congratulations and thank you so much. But I wanted to bring something up that has been discussed before on the show. It was brought up by Trace and Dr. Cannon. It's the idea that we are in this weird intersection, right, where we're trying to filter out a lot of the what is really fake influence that has come into black culture and black entertainment. It's where it's effectively these white-owned corporations presenting their interpretation of what black life is and how that goes. And we're trying to get to that place where we put out those positive aspects that really exalt what black life actually is, the things that we go through and the story that really tells the story of us. It's a hot topic right now with so many things going on the internet, hate speech and all these sorts of things. And then those people who want to try to blend in the idea of speaking of the black experience as being something like that for the purposes of just basically being trifling, honestly. How do you guys see being able to kind of broach that weird intersection that we're in right now? Thank you.
Well, you can get that one. I'll chime in on the back end.
No worries. So I believe we have two perspectives that we have to address almost immediately. Number one, we have to look at it from the viewpoint of the content creator, and they have to start having the courage and the foresight to know that I have to look at a different platform or a different medium or another way to disseminate my content and achieve my goals. Right now, you have so many people that are so keyed in on being successful that they almost say they're going to do it by any means necessary. and they're going to use the tools and the avenues that they feel is going to get them there the fastest way and to give them the most bang for their buck. And unfortunately, it's those same institutions and platforms and mediums that are taking advantage of them and perpetrating the same egregious behaviors that we see being persistent. They have to say, you know what, I'm not going to do it. I'm going to search and find a platform or create one to make sure that we're represented the way that we truly want to be represented. Then the second perspective is those that are actually watching the content. They have to start again, make a decision, create an awareness to where I'm not going to support or patronize those platforms, those venues, or those areas where that type of content, that type of behavior, and those processes are happening, and either search out other mediums to support or create one. And once we can start doing that, we can start slowly solving the problem, because now there are options, viable options, that people can use to get what they need done. And one of the challenges that we face thus far is that we have this real, real dynamic tool, an option. However, there are those that would be more than happy to use the mainstream platforms, knowing what they're going to get, knowing that they're not going to get full equity, knowing that they're going to be used, and knowing these things, they'd rather use those platforms than one that they clearly see will put them in a better position, but is not as well known or is not packaged the way that they want it to be packaged.
So, hi, this is Dr. Moncrief, and I'm very, very proud of you two gentlemen and what you're trying to do, but I need some help. I need some help with understanding exactly what we are talking about, because when I first heard platform, I was thinking of like hosting platforms that you're creating a space for people to come in and join and put their information on, and then I heard platform being used not as a technical hosting place, but as a place for people to have a voice, like tonight. On the Dr. Mary Lee show, we give people an opportunity to have a voice. What kind of platform exactly are we talking? Are we talking about a hosting platform like Amazon, or are we talking about a place to give people a voice?
So it's, so to answer a question, Dr., LiveWaves is a social network that's on the event platform that gives content creators the ability to monetize their content via live streaming. So, for example, you know, if you have a podcast, a radio show, if you're a dancer, if you're a singer, a rapper, if you're a politician, if you're a chef, you know, our platform, you know, gives you the ability and the vehicle to not only monetize your content, you know, via live streaming to go along with our other features, but also it gives you the ability to have a voice and the platform, your content, your craft, your gifts, anywhere in the world. And so, you know, that's encompassed by all the features that are included on the app. So, for example, if we were able to get, for example, Kevin Hart on the app, for example. So let's say Kevin Hart wanted to do a comedy special, you know, he'll be able to, you know, charge his fan base whatever he wants at his price points, right? Or let's say, for example, if we have, like, you know, like a local chef from Chicago who wants to do a, you know, like a cooking special on the show, he'll be able to live stream that content or that show on the spot and charge, you know, his fan base or his followers his price points, right? Or let's say, for example, we're talking about a movie director, a producer, right, who's doing like a short film. You know, they'd be able to pre-record that content and upload it on the app you know, for their price point. You know, so it's a platform that you can host concerts, you can host comedy shows, you can host events, you can host promotions, you know, you can talk about politics, you can host a radio show. On the platform, the idea of it was to create a one-stop shop for any type of creator. So one, you know, they could control and own their content, but B, also control and their revenue at a very, very unlimited standpoint.
And so I'm just going to jump in here. Like Dr. Moncrief, I believe that if I'm following correctly, say just like our show, the Dr. Mary Lee Life Show, well, we're joining forces, you know, we're partnering, you know, with Live App. Right now, we're broadcasting through Blog Talk Radio. And so we can come on here, do just what we're doing. We can talk. This is live stream right now. It's going all over the world. People can pick this here up. Doesn't matter what part of the world they're in, they can pick it up and listen to us by internet and by dialing in and participate in the conversation, you know, by tapping one. But they do have to call in order to participate. And so the Live App can do the same thing, right? And it's distributed on other platforms. Am I correct? Now, with Blog Talk, you know, it's linked, you know, by the internet, so they can anywhere. We have listeners, believe it or not, you guys, and I don't know why they're listening to us in China, but you know, I kind of went over where our listeners are. So two, and I think this is significant, and I don't know what it means, and maybe somebody out there might, but, you know, 2.5, almost 2.5% of our listeners are in China. Why would they be listening to us? We've got, you know, percentage in the UK. I can't remember. It's a good one. You know, Africa and, you know, other places. But this Live App have the same ability. Am I correct?
Well, let me speak to some, just clarify a couple of things, Dr. Mir, and please forgive me. LiveWaves is a platform and a medium where you now have a culture that's not allowing any type of bias control.
Mm-hmm.
There's no
mm-hmm.
algorithmic control or hindrances to content, meaning we're looking for individuals that are willing to give truth and not have
mm-hmm.
to worry about being censored or being put in being shadow banned or putting in some type of banned situation because based on their political views, personal views, whatever the case may be. So when you have a medium
mm-hmm.
that's black owned and black ran, and we have purpose to make sure that everyone has the full autonomy to speak what they need to speak in the fashion,
mm-hmm.
how they want to do it, when they want to do it. They can do it for free or for pay, but we give the control
mm-hmm.
to the person that's going to be providing the content. Now, we're live streaming. We're not an audio platform. Now, of course, we do allow for the uploading of music or audio content in the form of songs or playlists or posts so that people can listen to audio content that's pre-recorded, but the audio engagement that would happen on our app would be through the live streams that are done on the app.
Okay. And I'm lost.
Okay.
I always get lost after a second or two.
This is Dr. Moncrief. So I hear you saying what you're calling Live App is actually a hosting platform where programs can and people can come on your a hosting platform and have their, like the Dr. Mary Lee Show can get on your platform and be shown live. Or you can have somebody, I think you gave the example, Kevin Hart can have a comedy show that he can put on your platform either for free or at a fee. And then he can do his comedy show live off of your platform. But you're the hosting platform. You're the place where people can come and they can speak their truth. They can get on your platform and speak their truth and not have to be worried about somebody coming in and controlling what they have to say. Do I have it right now?
Dr. Mindcreep, you are hitting the nail right on the head. And we do so in a fashion. So if you were to marry, like you said, Netflix, iTunes, TikTok, YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, all those other platforms into one app, you have our app. So we do everything they do and more because they all don't do what we do because we do everything they do. So it's an important platform because we take the best of all the other ones and put it together, and we allow for free. Like it's like a free reign on what you want to do, just as long as it's legal. Now, we don't promote and we don't accept any type of illegal activity because our app is built for 9 to 90. We want to protect those that need protected, but we also want to make sure that everyone has the freedom to do what they need to do.
And for those who have been with us for a while, if you can remember when we were, Dr. Moncrief, I think this is when we were with the COVID-19, when we had those specials and the truth was being told about, you know, what was going on, and they cut us off midstream, remember?
Yes.
Yep. They cut us off midstream when one of our guests, who was a doctor, was sharing her experience. So those things can happen. We've been cut off several times, censored. We've been censored several times.
Yes, so having a platform where we could, you know, actually come on, a platform where you can actually put your program on and not be afraid that somebody's going to censor you. Okay, as long as you are giving out correct information is crucial. And having a black-owned one, guys, you're really ahead of the game.
Thank you.
That's what I'm excited about.
Right. So
Dr. Long, you want to
other part of
here?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh,
I'm
go
sorry.
Ahead.
Go ahead.
No, go ahead. No, go ahead. No, go ahead, Jared.
Oh, I was just saying the other part of my question, I guess, with that is like, how then are we going to inspire, you know, those of us who are out there and those truth makers and truth speakers to you know, follow along with where we're going with that? You know, because I know that the idea of representing black a lot better than a lot of these things that have been out there is near and dear to me and my heart, and anything that I would create, I would, you know, carry myself down that road. But there are others who, you know, they kind of need that inspiration to know that there's a group of people out there who are trying to do this sort of a thing. So how do you guys see, like, kind of, you know, promoting that on the app while still keeping true to the tenets you just expressed?
Well, that's a twofold question, Doctor. I would say, one, that kind of work or inspiration goes beyond the app, right? It goes beyond the camera. So in that, you know, we have to do like a grassroots campaign where we do conventions, where we do like a live panel discussion, you know, where we're educating and teaching people from a hands-on standpoint, where we're directly invoking inspiration and motivation to their psyches, right, to their mindsets. That's one. But two, there has to be a paradigm shift from an overall standpoint. We're in that, you know, where we have to totally change the thought process, you know, the thinking, the mindset for the masses. And that's a day-by-day process. That's something that can't be done in a week, in a month or in a year. You know, that's a lifelong commitment for people who do know better, right? Who do understand, you know, have a higher understanding, more knowledge, more wisdom, where we reach back and say, hey, listen, this is what I learned. This is what God showed me, and do it that way. All right?
And if I can just piggyback, if I can just piggyback, because there's something you can do right now, sir. You can become a scientist and ask why, ask questions, and find out for yourself. When you hear about an app that does what we say does, well, check it out. Do your research. Find out if it's true. And once you find out it's true and it does what it's supposed to do and what these guys are saying is correct, you need to promote it, use it, and tell everyone you know, become a cheerleader about this app. Listen, you got to understand, this. I don't know if you're familiar with this app called Clubhouse. And Clubhouse, if you're not familiar, is a glorified chat line. We have people that go on the app and have audio conversations. They go in these rooms and talk, like the party lines. Now, since the advent of Clubhouse, people have gone on that app and blown it up to where on last year they got a valuation of $1 billion based upon 1 million users. And all they do is have people come into rooms and chat. Now, if we can have the same type of engagement with all other platforms that fit a certain need or meet a desired outcome, then we too can have that level of success in what we're trying to promote. Now, we know Clubhouse is not a black-owned, black-ran platform, but LiveWaves is. We have to start promoting, pushing, cheerleading things that fit into what we're trying to prescribe to so that we know that we did our part to get it to where it needs to be. And if everyone did that and it takes hold like it's supposed to, then we can accelerate and expedite certain platforms and some of our pursuits.
Okay, so what you're saying is that the exact thing that Clubhouse offers and does, we can do the same thing with Live App.
Nope, not what they provide and do, the engagement. Because what Clubhouse, they just talk. What LiveWaves does is a million times more.
Okay. Let me back up. So one of our other ventures, we're involved with the funding lead. Okay, and so and also you know Dr. James Cannon, and so Dr. Cannon, considering doing, we've been discussing, is to take the grant development, the entrepreneur development, to Clubhouse, you know, because they got all these different rooms and you can be on there for so many hours and people are all over the place and you can go from one room to the next room and invite people over. And so now, is this a capability? You know, how does Live App line up with what Clubhouse does? And then there's also another platform called, pardon me?
Yeah, I was going to say the same type of engagement that you do on Clubhouse, you can do on LiveWaves. The biggest difference is Clubhouse is only audio. LiveWaves is video and audio. So you can have rooms.
Okay.
Each profile is not only just a room, but it's a station. It's a network.
Mm-hmm.
You can create your own network on LiveWaves. So you can either have a Netflix type of engagement where you have a subscription-based service where you have content that you charge a monthly price like Netflix or Hulu, or you can have different rooms that you set up or profiles so that you can have your own channel where people come to see specific content that you put out. And individuals can switch from room to room or profile to profile based upon the content that's being provided on that day or that particular time.
Okay. So basically the only difference is size, because they've been out there for a while.
That's it.
That's so the only difference,
no, the big
is
difference
size,
is,
right?
Nope. The difference is they have a product that's one-dimensional. We have a product in 6D. They've grown because they've been around longer. They had people that decided to use that platform.
So I get it. So so Live App offers more, but they're the size they are because they've been out there longer. But we have, over time we can work together, and Live App can really supersede where they are.
Correct.
Okay. And that's fine with me because, you know, we've made them enough money. I have no issue, and I hope that anyone listening, you know, our people, our team, I hope that none of you out there would have any issue with maybe a smaller audience as we grow ourselves, because that's what Neighborhood Commerce is about. That's what Dr. Mary Lee Live is about. That's what all of us are about. We want to be able to, and we can still share the audio or the video, you know, on these other platforms, you know, their platforms as we do already. But it can all be created. We can do all of our creation, all of our distribution, all of our production of Live Apps, right?
Yes, ma'am. And listen, by no means are we saying that you should not use those other platforms. That would be irresponsible, and that would be unfair, because any content creator or any business, they should have a marketing plan. And the social media or the digital marketing plan should include any demographic or any place where they can get viewers or people to view their content. We're just saying, if you're going to use those platforms, do that, but don't exclude the platform that's going to be a better fit and speak to your agenda more than the other ones. And as we grow, the demographic that we have exposed you to will be greater because we have more to offer.
Okay.
All right. Yeah, I'm listening, and I do have some questions, but part of my questions, I guess, are related to a nonprofit that we established some years ago, and some content that we have, I guess it's floating out there, and we really haven't acted on it. And I'll just give an example. Back in 2020, our nonprofit, we put on a close to a 10-hour program entitled Mental Health and Musical Genius, or Musical Genius and Mental Health, where it was at the Charles Wright Museum. We paid for filming, editing, and all that, but unfortunately, it was just sitting. I hate to say it was an indictment on black folks doing business. So that 3 years later, this product is just sitting there. So I was just wondering, and I'm hoping one of the members of our nonprofit, attorney Russell Smith, is listening on, that can maybe chime in as well and give more insight in terms of what we need or what we should do. So, and I'm looking at the the app here with branding and things like that. So. And we have other products that we just haven't moved. We met with a person who created an app called Black Doctor Dot org or blackdoctor.com, and we thought that was going to be our a possible connection, but it kind of fell through, even though we thought we had a lot of content, which we still do. So I don't know if I have a question, or I just wanted you guys to listen to that that particular scenario that our nonprofit, which is called LLSM Behavioral Initiatives, that we still, I guess, are trying to deal with. And our goal with this group was to provide behavioral health, mental health services initially for police officers, which was our initial venture where we're looking at all the shootings, and we were exploring different psychological testing that's outdated to explain why we have all the shootings and things like that. But it was a list of different things that we were trying to focus on. So with that being said, I'm hoping, again, Russ Smith is listening as well. He can probably add a little bit more in terms of our dilemma and see where you guys may, you know, first of all, what you guys think, and then see if we can, employ your services to see to move us ahead. We have a lot of material, like I said, but it's just sitting.
Well, if I could speak real quickly, and Don, you can chime in. A part of a nonprofit as well, it's very possible. I can tell you one of the main focuses of every nonprofit is fundraising. Most of our time is spent looking for ways to raise funds for programming, for administration, for operations, for facility, all those things. Now, what we can assist in is twofold. Number one, you have a platform or medium that doesn't cost any money to use. So you start off without any overhead or no upfront cost to use the app, whether it be streaming, uploading content, or whatever the case may be. So now the onus is on you is to become creative as to what kind of programming can you put in place that's visual or audio where people would pay for, so that you can now have a fundraiser with no upfront cost. Now, while you're doing that fundraiser, if it's a video or live stream or a concert or an event, you can have that event be for free, hence like a telethon. So you can have a telethon on the app that's free. And so whatever the content may be, you choose it. And then what happens is we have this button that's live in our stream that allows a person to donate or give you financial compensation right through the app. So you didn't pay any money to stream or upload your content. The only cost that you would incur was if you were having it at a venue that charged you to use the venue and the cost it would be to put on the program. However, you now have the app that allows you to have no cost for any streaming or dissemination of your product. It's all pure profit.
And also, okay. I want to assist with that also, you know, we can help with, you know, if you're talking about, you know, mental health and behavioral health as it relates to, you know, police officers, and, you know, that's a very, very broad subject, one. But two, you know, we can help you, you know, curate, you know, different events, different summits, different conventions that specifically highlights the mental health for police officers, because, you know, we all know that they have a very, you know, high impact job. It's very stressful. It's very, you know, grueling day in and day out. And so, but also, furthermore, you know, once we, you know, help, you know, put together perhaps an event or a convention or a summit or a podcast or a fundraiser, also, you know, we can help, you know, garner sponsorships as well for the events, right? Media presence for the events, right? So we have a very, very, you know, superstar talent roster. We have people on our board that have a plethora of, you know, different skill sets, backgrounds, resources, connections. So anything that you bring us that's viable, you know, we can enhance it times 10, definitely.
Okay.
You know, I really like this. I really like this. I want to first I want to give Dr. Russell, if you're on, Dr. Long would like for you to tap 1 on your phone so that you can join us and speak. So if you're here, you know, tap 1 on your phone and we can open your line. And also, you know, I would like for our show technology people and IT people who are on here who understand this much better than I do to get on here and ask questions. And I know you have questions, and I know you have thoughts, and I know you have comments. So let's not I would like for you to while we have these our guests here, I'd like for you to join us and help clarify some of this for me. But I've got, as you were speaking, you know, I'm really excited because you're working with so many different organizations and so many different entrepreneurs. I mean, like one after another. You know, I'm thinking that maybe we can, we can bring them, you know, each one of them on and onto this app, and you guys, you know, help, you know, our show, help the Dr. Mary Lee Live show to produce them. And I love the idea about the telethons, you know, and how we can get the word out about what all of us are doing. And I think this, I feel this is the perfect match, really, you know, just sent from our creator. I mean, it's something that I've been hoping for and praying for, not knowing what, because I don't know very much, okay, when it comes to technology. You know, but I'm a good listener, Dr. Long. And so I'm understanding more, and I believe that this is an answer to what we've been looking for, as well as, you know, Dr. Cannon. I mean, we've got a lot of things in the making. I mean, a lot of things we've been working on for years, not just this show. This is going to be the perfect platform for everything pretty much that we've been working on to roll out, including, you know, the doctors, our, you know, promoting the new black medical schools, our federally qualified healthcare centers, everything that we're working on. I can see it happening. But this is what we need. This is what we need to get the word out, because, you know, it's changed. You know, life has changed. Okay, 313. Your hand is up, 2787. You are live.
This is Russ Smith. Dr. Long has just called me out.
Okay.
I guess the question I have for the platform folks is, how is it just live streaming, or is it something that you can have stored media on there, regular, let's say, things like that?
So right now, we had a notion that in order to protect the intellectual property of our content providers and not allow other platforms access, we only had the live stream to be not recorded. That means if it's live, then you don't have to worry about someone reproducing it. And we have technology based in the app to where it can't be screen recorded for someone else to get your intellectual property and re-disseminate it. We don't give access to YouTube, those other platforms, because we couldn't control how they would take your content and redistribute it. So it's live streaming at this point, without it being recorded, and we have some updates coming that will change that in the future based upon the request of some of the artists that are coming on the app. But there's two engagements, live streaming or uploaded content. So you can upload content onto the app, and you can upload up to 3 hours of content per upload. So you can essentially upload a whole full-length movie in the app for distribution, when you want to distribute it, and how you want it to monetize.
Okay. So you can actually password protect or otherwise protect who sees it as well?
Yes. So a person, okay. if you provide the content for free, then you can allow anyone to view it. But if you protect it, they have to purchase, you get a set of price and have to purchase the ticket to view the app, then they will not be able to see the content without going through your profile and obtaining the rights to see the stream or content by paying the fee.
Okay. Sounds good. Yeah, I guess, yeah, like Dr. Long said, we had tried a couple of venues and events, and this might be a good way of doing this because we could do it without incurring at least the physical costs of the space, you know. And, yeah, that sounds good. And you said you have what's the quality of the video? Is it like 4K or some other kind of high speed or high quality video?
It's however you want it to be. So we know that the cell phones these days have amazing cameras and microphones. So we found out that the quality of the video and audio by using your cell phone is amazing. But let's say that you're not good, that's not good enough for you. Well, then you can now use a 4 or 5K camera. You can hook it up through your laptop or your desktop to your soundboard to have stadium quality sound. So it's just based upon the level of engagement and quality that you want to have your content shown at, and you have the option to do it. Sometimes it's beneficial to use a phone. Sometimes you want to use your 5K cameras and your high-end mics to stream your content.
Mm-hmm. Okay, sounds good.
I knew we were going to have some harder questions than this, guys.
I have a question for you, or maybe something that you can help me understand. I'm still back in the basics again. So, but you call yourself Life App. Are you an application
LiveWaves,
or are you a platform? Okay. But are you an application or are you a platform? And please define for us the difference between being a platform versus being an application. Because you said now you can come on your application. That's different than coming on a platform. So can you explain that to us?
Yes, ma'am. So the application is you have an app that you can download on your phone or your tablet or your or Chromebook type of event, just like Facebook, Instagram, and those guys, where you can use your mobile device to get access to this platform. Where we're also a platform to where you can also engage with us through your laptop or your desktop, where we have a website that has the same functionality as the mobile application to do your engagement with your content to the people that are following you.
So Dr. Lee is excited about being able to download your app, and then by downloading your app, she can put her program on your platform?
Yeah, so it's the same thing. It's just that it depends on the type of engagement you want to have. If you want to engage through a mobile device, like cell phone, tablet, then you would use the mobile application. If you want to engage through your laptop or desktop computer, then you go to livewaves.app and engage through the platform.
Okay, so, but okay, so we want LiveWaves LLC, your company, to do all the work, basically. So that's the only way I work. That's the only activity does.
I love that.
And so in doing all the work, I think Dr.
Dr. Moncrief, I believe her question is really kind of based on, like, you guys doing the work, we just showing up, or whether we show up, you know, on the YouTube, however way you video it, whether we show up on the app or show up in person, you know, we need you all to do it, you know, do the cameras, do whatever is needed.
We do that now. So we have our own crews that have cameras. So we show up to events. We do the live streaming. We do recording. Listen, we're full service. We understand that
okay. We
have to make sure that anything you need to help us get content and grow this app, we're going to do it.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Sounds good to me, you guys. Now, to the funding lead team, all of y'all on here so quiet, and I'm just going to get the fussing, you know, our next meeting. If some of y'all don't get up here and say something, if you tap one, I don't care which one of you do it, I know y'all on here. I need you to say something. I need you to let me know what your thoughts are on here.
Dr. Lee, while you're waiting for them to tap one, can you ask the young men with this wonderful idea, how do they make their money to stay in business to do this?
Yes.
I haven't heard that.
that's a great question.
You know what? Let's not talk about that. They might want to charge me.
Go ahead.
Dom, do you want to handle that or do you want me to?
Yeah, I'll take care of it. So that's a great question. And so what it is, you know, but by us having a platform that provides, to give the content creator the ability to keep all the revenue. Let's say, for example, someone was doing a cooking show, right, and they wanted to charge, you know, their audience $10. The company,
mm-hmm.
us LiveWaves, will just charge the client a surcharge. So for example, if your price was $10, then we said, hey, give us $2.50. And so in total, it'd be like $12.50 for the ticket. And so that's one of the ways that we get paid as a company.
Mm-hmm.
The other way is, mm-hmm. Of course, you know, getting sponsorships and sponsors for various events as well.
Mm-hmm. Right, and we can help do that. Neighborhood Commerce can help with sponsorship, and then we our grant development, kind of what I'm looking at. In partnering so that we can, and then of course we have, okay, somebody responded from the team, I think. Okay, who is 443-4142? 443-4142, you're live.
Hi, it's Brenda. So that was my question about the money, because I'm interested in doing a podcast. So, you know, I have to know what the bottom line is and how much it would be, like the other podcasting companies. Nobody's free.
Well, can I help you with something?
Sure.
We have no rights to your intellectual property. So one of the components that sets us apart from everyone else, and we did this is our
mm-hmm.
business model, this is how we know we're going to win, that you get 100% of what you charge. We're on all the nuances, we're putting a small fee on top. So that's one revenue. Now, of course, in an app like this, there's gonna be ads sold, right? Because it, you know, people wanna take advantage of the population. So we have a ad based model that's not algorithmically based to where people are forced to see ads. We have a unique ad model to where we have certain profiles in certain areas that you can opt in or out to see ads on the app. So that's going to bring in major profit for us, because now people, based upon their geographic area, the demographic, their industry, they now can go places to see ads, or they can choose whether to get hit with ads or not. So we have a great model of making us tons of money, so our stockholders are going to be happy, and we're going to make our content providers happy because they can get everything they need and get more bang for their buck than anybody else.
Wow. And just how much is that bang for the buck? How much is it? I need a bottom line for an hour podcast or a half hour podcast. I'm not charging anybody for it.
So if you don't charge anybody for it, it's free. So we don't make money unless you make money. And that's just a simple premise. The bang for the buck is based upon how much you want to charge. If you charge $10, you get $10. If you charge $1,000, you get $1,000. If you charge $1, you get $1. And that model is not consistent amongst any of those other apps or platforms because they only give a monetization percentage of when you reach a certain goal, or they give you what they want to give you.
Right.
And so, Brenda, with sponsors can help offset their expenses, LiveWaves expenses. And so this is one way of their being able to provide it, you know, at cost, you know, at or for free pretty much, you know, because it's just like, you know, you're getting a grant and you're serving people for no charge because the grant is covering the expenses for the production. But one thing that is really, really good about what they're doing when they speak about the not being the ownership. And so this is a program project that James Cannon, and he has communicated with me tonight, and he may still be able to get on. But now he's bringing forth a series where he'll be bringing on some entertainers who have been, you know, right where, who are even today, right where LiveWaves does not want us to go. It doesn't want to keep the ownership to your property, to your art, and, you know, to you. You know, it where without taking any ownership to any content. And so they're going to be, he's working on bringing on some entertainers, a series of entertainers who are caught up in the system, and we're going to be talking about some who have died mysteriously, and they have, you know, they have reasons for their death, like Prince and Michael Jackson and all this, but we don't know and don't understand. I mean, you see those fights in court that go on after their death. Who owns what? Well, this isn't what's going to happen with LiveWaves. It's set up where it will never happen. And not only that, the artists are more valuable financially to their distributors like Universal and others, dead than alive, because they carry insurance on them, and it's a hefty insurance. They have become millionaires, you know, on the back of our black entertainers, and some whites too, but, you know, us majorly, with certain types of insurances. And, you know, just these ownerships of content. And so we want to stay totally and completely free of their claws. And so that we can build our communities financially and retain ownership to our own creations. You know, we've got writings, we've got a lot that to get out there, and you know, they'll be more than happy to produce the movie, right, and be part owner of it. But I like this because, you know, they're not, LiveWaves isn't asking for any type of ownership. And so I hope I made some sense. Go ahead, Brenda.
No, I'm complete. I just wanted to know how, you know, just the cost. I have a budget.
Okay, we appreciate
and I understand
you so much.
That if I don't charge, they don't charge. I understood that.
Okay, great, great. Yes, thank you. Thank you, team member. Do we have any other team members out there who don't want to be fussed at?
Dr.
Lee,
I do have a question.
Yes.
Hello?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. This is Dr. Lons again, and I hate to put Attorney Russell Smith on the spot, but with this program tonight, I just can't help myself. So,
that's okay.
Russell Smith.
Not really.
Hopefully he's still on the line. But I'm looking at blog. I'm looking at a blog associated with one of his inventions dating back in the 80s, associated with Black Factor, Afrocentric playing cards. And in this blog, it mentions the name of a Mr. Virgil Abloh, who Russ had the fortune to make a collaboration with. But my question is, in terms of your company, I've heard Russ talk about his cards somehow being on an app, and I know we had reached out to a person who attended U of M with us in terms of trying to make that happen. So is that something that you all do as well?
So I'm sorry. Please forgive me. I'm not the brightest bulb in the bunch. So the question was lost on me.
What's the question again?
So
what are you asking?
Is that Russ?
Yes.
Okay, Russ, you ask the question.
I don't know what I'm not. I don't know
on.
What you're getting at.
You mentioned before.
I don't think they do any development work. That's what you're asking,
we'll see.
I believe.
But since they're online, you can ask them for yourself.
This is so unrelated to anything that we're talking about right now. It's kind of hard to conceive. What Kurt is talking about, last year I had a connection with Virgil Abloh, and it was right before he passed away. And we created a design of a card. And, you know, since then I've relaunched my cards, which have been around since the 80s. So, I mean, it's not a platform. There's a thought that I could possibly do a software version of some playing card games or something like that, or maybe a 3D room or some other, you know, interactive space. But I really haven't thought it out any further than just a concept, you know, and I think that's what he's trying to get at.
Go ahead.
So that would be a Wyrd Ventures engagement. So Wyrd Ventures Incorporated is a IT company. So we develop software, we develop programs, we develop mobile applications. So a person like yourself would engage with us, and we would enter into an agreement or contract to develop the technology for you. Of course, in that engagement, we would determine the details and terms of that engagement on who has or on what the dynamics are. So that's something that you would go to a developer or someone to help you develop it, and you work out the terms of your agreement.
Yeah, because there's been some talk. I mean, there's plenty of versions of games, but you know, the only thing that would be different from my product, if I was going to go, it would be my own art designs on it, and you know, maybe some other little twists that I could put into to it, but probably nothing really substantially different in the beginning. So okay, so is this the same company or as you or no?
Yes, so Wyrd Ventures is the creator of LiveWaves.
Wyrd Ventures. Okay, because I came on late. I wasn't sure if that had been mentioned. Okay.
Yes, sir.
You have a website or?
Absolutely. Go to Wyrd Inc. WYRDINC for the Wyrd Ventures, and you go to livewaves.info. For the LiveWaves information, you can learn about both of our companies. Scrutinize us, vet us, man. Do whatever you got to do. I just want you to know everything you need to know about us, so you can support us, patronize us, and push us to the top.
Oh yeah, well it's mutual. So I mean, that would be because I did have somebody I spoke to about developments, but you know, I was kind of way down on their list, so I really didn't push it. Right now, I'm just kind of dealing with the physical product right now, but there's a virtual space that I have thought about trying to develop, and I guess that's what Kurt was getting at. So,
we got you, brother. And again, it pays dividends to deal with a black-owned, and black-run company because you know,
absolutely.
We got you in mind.
Yeah, that's all I want to do. I mean, there's enough of the others out there. Are you guys familiar with the site Narrative and Nubia with Dr. Carr and Karen Hunter?
I am not. Dom, are you?
No, sir.
Okay. Yeah, it was something that kind of sprouted up during the COVID. And I'm sorry? And this is... There's a Dr. Carr out of Howard University and Karen Hunter who has a Sirius XM radio show, and they've actually kind of worked on some of the model that we are just talking about. They have a interactive sort of social media site, and then they also have a more static web page where they're hosting like educational programs and stuff like this. And these are all, you know, as I say, blackety black black shows. You know, so, and they're trying to stay far away from the mainstream media as well. So it might be a good connection at some point, you know, to do that. I'll try to contact you on your site and give you some exposure to those things.
We appreciate that.
Awesome. Yeah, I mean it's because they just live stream some stuff out of the San Diego Comic Con. They had a Black Heroes Matter show out there. Some of the people are in this other thing. They were dealing with what was going on out there, and so it's kind of interesting. I mean, just you know, seeing live productions, you know, in real time is always good. So.
Yeah, you know, we want to support them. Listen, there's so much market that it's enough for everybody. We just need more black people in tech, more black people streaming, more black people on social media, because we need to be a player in this industry.
Right.
We got to control the narrative.
Absolutely. So, yeah, that's great. It sounds like you guys are in the same boat. Do you already have some running content, or is it just always with new people coming in and you're just kind of doing that?
Dom, what you say?
Yeah, so we have plenty of content. We actually just had a mental health awareness fair last week. That was one.
Oh, okay.
Also, we have the comedian Joe Torre, who is the director of our comedy department. He has a radio, his own radio show actually, on the app, and as well as, you know, snippets of his comedy shows that he does throughout the country. We have a spoken word artist as well on the app. We have quite a few content creators that are right now currently running content on the app every day. Every day.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I know one of the things that Dr. Longs is a big fan of is the theater too. There's a lot of content there that he's trying to bring out into not just spoken word, but you know, actually stage works and things like that. So,
you know, we would love that. We're actually looking for more people to do stage play, things of that sort, operas, mm-hmm. you know. Whatever it is, anything that's going to.
So your actual content creators are also your producers and directors and writers, or do you guys just do some of the film and editing and other things like that?
Yeah, so
it's
both. So it's both, yes.
Okay, you do have some writers as well?
Yes. You guys just live streamed something really huge in Detroit, right? Some events. I can't remember what it was.
We've live streamed a couple of concerts. We live streamed this really dope event called Michigan Fashion Week. So we are looking for content, and we know that we can't. Our users can't wait for certain demographics. So we're in the process of being content creators ourselves to make sure that we have a robust engagement for all of our people on that.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's great.
Yeah.
Speaking of content.
Collectively, I think that, I know, you know, we can look for some funds and or do something amongst ourselves where we collaboratively get, you know, all of our projects. I'd love to see happen, but we would need to do it together because they're corporate sponsors and foundations and organizations that definitely, you know, would support. And so I'm very excited about this. Very excited about
it.
So I'm going to say to the team members that you all can thank Brenda for us going to have a very good meeting the next time, and I don't have to fuss at anybody. So you guys, thank Brenda for that tonight, okay? I know you're here.
Thank you, Brenda.
And,
thank you.
I'll give you one last chance to tap one on your phone and say something. And I'm really going to fuss at our technical people who are working so diligently all the time for the past 3 years, are we? And they never say anything or, you know, but they continue to serve. So I want to thank you. So we're wrapping it up now. We've got to wrap things up. And so we're just going to go around as we typically do. They're going to be the last speakers. So we'll start with Jared and Dr. Moncrief. And Russell, you're not getting out of this, so you'll have some more to say along with Dr. Longs and Dr. Moncrief. So if I missed anyone, it's okay. You just jump in here anyway. So, Jared.
Roger. Thank you, Dr. Lee. Always humbled. Always a great experience. I enjoyed the laughs tonight. To the two gentlemen who are doing this again, it's a paradigm shift that, you know, you guys are black guys in tech, and you're doing it, you know, with a plan and a process, and you're going to, you know, move and shift that view. That's absolutely wonderful to me. You know, I look forward to seeing a lot more of that as a thing. And then, you know, us being able to own the black narrative and put more of that, you know, what I refer to as good glue out there, which are those things that really bring back the humanization of black people and black culture.
and gets us away from, you know, a lot of these things that have been pushed out there as things that are trying to own the narrative in another way and describe us in another way and completely exempt us from the actual humanity that's there. So thank you and God bless. I did have a question about content filtering, but, you know, I guess we can table that for later. I was just kind of wondering if,
you did a show with a controversial
topic. How do you not appear next to, like, Drill Music Joe because you mentioned drill music
we'll table that because hopefully, you know, Dr. Cannon is working on this project and we will bring him back. We would be thinking that we will bring LiveWaves back and be a part of that Bell shows, and so we can talk about that then. But we do have a hand that has gone up, and I do want to recognize 865.
Roger. I yield my time, Dr. Lee. They can have it.
Thank you. Thank you. 865-0704.
Hi, Miss Mary. I'm part of the team, and do you know what I want to do? A fat person's exercise program.
Okay, that sounds interesting.
Because you always see skinny people doing exercise shows.
Okay.
So I'm overweight, and people could. I mean, this would be a great platform. But anyway, thank you for everything. Thank you for the show. Love you all. Bye.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much, Miss Ivy. That's part of the team. People don't want me fussing. But anyways, hey, you guys, so could something like that can be aired, right? You guys can handle that, right?
Yes. Miss Ivy, we are doing in October, we are doing something called the 40-year anniversary. It's called the Fooled and Fabulous Gala. And that gala is going to actually honor women who are plus size, right? Like a fashion show for plus size women. And the woman that played in the movie Precious, what's her name? She's actually the host of the show. And so absolutely, you know, we could definitely handle something like that where we want to people who don't get the notoriety or, you know, or the attention, we would love to do something like that for you as well.
That's great. She's gone, but thank you so much. Looks like we've got somebody else who's raising up a hand. To error code 248, and the last four digits are 2766.
That's me, Dr. Lee, Dr. Mary. It's Michael Dorsey.
Oh, so you must have dropped and gang back on. Okay. Hey,
yes.
Okay, so we're going to get back around to you. We want to get to everyone else. Okay. So, so you did drop off. Okay. So, Dr., where are we? Oh, Dr. Moncrief. Oh, hold it up. Just before you, we're going to. Dr. James Cannon, thank you. I know what you're going through, and you're extremely, extremely busy, but we're glad you're here. Don't know how much you've been able to hear tonight, but we've got these two fabulous gentlemen on, and we've been talking about everything regarding live streaming, the platform for LiveWaves and what they do with the app and, you know, how they compare to Clubhouse, and they're ready to take us on. Dr. Cam.
Well, so much is going on right now. The new frontier is the Internet. So any way that we can get in front of this thing and make sure our people, our churches, get in front of this thing as well. This new information highway really is just taking off. You know, it started many years ago with the Internet. Now with the blockchain coming in, you know, with our people being able to write books without publishing companies, with us being able to, you know, produce music without record labels, for us to be able to produce books, just an incredible time right now. And it looks like the new tools are changing, you know, weekly and monthly to make what we want to do easier. So having skilled young men that know this frontier and can help navigate us as a people, this new highway where we can go directly to our constituents, where we don't have to have a middleman, is just an incredible time, you know, to get the young people really fired up with this new technology. They know how to use these tools, but they're spending too much time just playing games. And so I'd like to see a nation full of young people that get it. They understand it. They become influencers in their own world. So I'm just excited about this show. I'm excited about what we're doing and what we can do together. And I just think this is the time for us to take over this new frontier and just be clever. We got everything we need. Need the motivation now to take it over, not just to get in, but to get in and dominate. That's what I see the opportunity. Dr. Lee, I appreciate this show. I'm going to listen to what I missed in the archive. The beauty of it is we can go back and listen to these shows in the archive. So I want to be able to respond. I want to be able to, you know, whatever I missed, I want to be able to catch up. And we have some more shows. We'll continue to do this together. I'm just excited as well.
Okay. The one thing that I want to mention, and Dr. Cannon, is that we talked about Clubhouse, and they our guests, you know, shared their how they compare to Clubhouse, and I would like, for since you're on, they do a little bit more than Clubhouse. So either one of you can jump in here and, you know, introduce yourself to Dr. Cannon, each one of you, please. And then just share a little bit. If you have any questions, he's definitely open.
Dr. Cannon, my name is Dominique McMullen. I really appreciate this opportunity. I'm glad that, you know, you were able to get something out of this. I definitely agree with you 100%. This is our time to dominate this space, you know, where we can influence, you know, young, old, people to actually create content that can, one, tell our stories, that can, two, you know, highlight, you know, our narratives and political control, and have a paradigm shift in different ways. But to answer a question just regarding the Clubhouse comparison, that we're our audio and visual, but also we have a plethora of features for the content creator, right? You know, we have the in-app ticketing feature, like Eventbrite, as to where, you know, you can pre-sell tickets. That's one. Two, we have a donate button for nonprofits, as to where you're not a charity, a foundation, and you're doing a charity event for your cause, you'll be able to have people watch your charity live stream anywhere in the world and donate live for that nonprofit, for that charity, for that cause. Three, we have a sound recording player that we call the Echo Player. With the Echo Player, you have the ability to upload your mixtape, your album, your singles to a platform and charge your fan base or your followers, whatever you want. We have a real feature like TikTok, as to where, you know, you can have like 30-second short videos, you know, to highlight, you know, your content or give a quick snippet for your brand. You know, for content creators, you know, we have a component where they can get paid on BBSCAN, right? That stands for Broadcast Data System, like radio scans. And so we have a plethora of different features that was specifically created for content creators to actually monetize their content to how they see fit, but also, you know, keep ownership and control of their content. So it's amazing. It's amazing.
Beautiful. But with, I don't know if the gentleman's going to speak to.
Yeah, well,
yes.
Man, he does such a great job. I didn't want to interrupt. But my name is Michael Dorsey. Dr. Cannon, I am the Chief Operations Officer of the company, and we just believe that we have an amazing product that is going to change people's lives. It's like giving an artist a lump of clay and telling them to go at it, and he turns that lump of clay into anything he can imagine. That's what we've done with this app, to where we have an all-encompassing, all-in-one tool for content creators, for both visual and audio content. And we have a culture to where, since we're Black-owned and Black-ran, and have an agenda to see our people be successful, I think we have an opportunity to do something significant and generational as we transfer through this space.
Beautiful. My question would namely be, and with the understanding that you understand Clubhouse, would you recommend, let's say, like us, Dr. Lee, and platforms like what we have, Blog Talk Radio, to utilize your platform and Clubhouse? Would it be a benefit for us if we want to dominate in the space of the Internet? Would it be beneficial for us to use both systems? Or would your system, mainly because it's Black-owned and we want to help and work along with Black companies, but would it be to our benefit to utilize your system, your app? And if you're familiar with Clubhouse, would you recommend us also to use Clubhouse, or would you just say drive all of our energy over into your platform and it will work for us? Namely because it's a Black-owned company, but would you recommend companies to use the platform of Clubhouse and yours together?
Now, if you want to start, I can finish, or I can start, you can finish. What do you want to do?
I'll start. To answer that question, I would say that definitely. I mean, if at the end of the day you have a brand and a business to promote, you know, it would be irresponsible for me to say to only use us only, right? But however, because I think I know we have the best platform that has the most to offer, in the long run, it makes sense to actually use our platform for all that we offer, right? One. But two, furthermore, it's Black-owned, it's Black-ran, and we are over here building a legacy and a platform that's going to dominate, you know, our stories, that's going to, you know, highlight our culture, and you know, that's going to change narratives and shift culture, you know, for the next 20 years. So to answer the question, I believe in the long run, it makes more sense, in my opinion, right, to use our platform so we can go ahead and build this platform to be the best platform for us, period.
Dr. Cannon, Clubhouse is a chat line. It's a glorified chat line, and it has limitations. So I think that you guys should sit down and put together a social media engagement plan that encompasses all of the social networks, because each one has their own culture, their own demographic. They have a different reach. So you use each one for what it provides for you based upon what your needs are. Most certainly, LiveWaves would be a major component of that, because we do more than what those other platforms do. But you have to, you know, figure out what each one does for you and how they're best going to suit your needs, and then govern yourself accordingly.
Well, Clubhouse allows you to set up a profile before you listen to any of their shows or any of their clubhouses, before you can enter up the clubhouse. They're actually a clubhouse that's open up for 5 hours at a time. How does your platform work in conjunction with being open up clubhouse where they come in and socialize daily in that club? They bring different content in that club. Do yours work like that, or does it work differently?
It has engagement like Facebook. It has an engagement like Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, Twitter. So you can create a profile that's your actual channel. And on your channel, you can have video engagement. You can have audio engagement. The difference is that with Clubhouse, you have engagement where you're talking and like you're on the phone. With LiveWaves, you have a profile where you're going to live stream content to your followers, and they will engage with you through a text chat engagement like with Instagram or Facebook.
Beautiful. I love it.
Okay. So
I'm sorry, too, and
so
I came in late. What was the name of the platform, the app? I'm sorry, I came in late.
LiveWaves. All one
live
word, plural.
Yep, LiveWaves.
What are you penetrating into the market at this particular time? How can we help? I know there's a huge market, but where are you in the marketplace at this time? Are you trailing and just being direct or looking at what Clubhouse has done over the last 2 years since launch? Are you in front of them or trailing them? Are you learning from them or are you pulling them into what you're doing?
So to be honest, we're not learning. We're ahead of everyone. We're ahead of Clubhouse. If we look at the product as it relates right now, our technology is above Facebook. It's above Instagram. It's above TikTok. It's above Netflix, because we do everything they do and more. The only reason that we're not as popular and don't have the usage, because we're newer and we haven't, people don't know about us. So what we're doing right now is we're letting people know about this great product so they can understand that they can use it, they need to use it, and when they use it, they will be better off.
Are there plans to go public with it? Far stock wise, and where are we there? And you know, I'd love to be able to get on the platform too and begin to bring all of our strength to it as well, and then let you know others know as well. I mean, the number one plus is Black owned. What city are you headquartered out of?
So we're headquartered out of Detroit, Michigan. And we are considered, we will go public, not in the near future, because we have some goals we want to set forth. But I want to let you know, right now, we are in the process of raising funds. So we are in our friends and family round of funding. Once we're done with this, we go to our Series A funding and Series B funding, because we understand that we need certain type of investment and sponsorship dollars to take this platform national. And once it goes national, then it's going to be an explosion. All of those are jumping on board now. They're going to reap great benefits because they were able to get in at the point where, you know, we're selling stock for cheap. And then it's going to grow, it's going to do well, and we're looking to be very lucrative to all those that continue, that decide and commit to run with us at this point.
And we are.
You know, it's just an incredible time. It's just incredible time right now for us as people that have struggled all our life trying to get ahead, you know, if we watch other ethnic groups come into this country and set up businesses and buy a property and become entrepreneurs ahead of us as a people. But with this new frontier of the internet and these new opportunities of selling merchandise, and what do you see I'm just curious, since you're in it, where do you see that we can do to move faster as a people so we don't get left behind in this new frontier? What if you were speaking to the pastors and the business, Black businessmen across the country, and we see what's going on with our young people, their apathy for it, how would this, you know, help, you know, us as a people rally around a strong business, a business that's going to the internet, this new frontier? Why is it valuable for us to, as a people, to understand that we can sell our books and our merchandising over a platform like you have and bring the riches back to the house instead of bringing the pain back to the
everybody benefits from us but us. How does this platform and this new frontier open up opportunities for us as a people? How do you see this is one of the greatest opportunities for us to be proactive right now with these opportunities and new tools that you're bringing to us?
Don, you want to start it off?
Yeah, so to answer a question, I think when you have something that's ground floor and groundbreaking, right, you have history. And it's about timing. You know, right now, you know, we're living the best time to be alive. You know, technology, information, economics is booming. The caveat is information, right? Being informed, you know, just knowing it, you know, being aware of it, right? And so with our platform, by us having a resource unlimited, you know, as long as you have a Wi-Fi connection, you know, your content can be seen. That's one. But two, the fact that we have a platform that's for us and by us, you know, where we can create our own stories, our own movies, our own narrative, and have ownership and control of our future, you know, of our content, of our money, and that will create a firestorm or create a movement that permeates to our neighborhoods locally, nationally, and worldwide. But furthermore, the fact that we have all these great minds, right, on the phone, you know, we got doctors, we have attorneys, we have entrepreneurs, you know, we have, you know, people who are like-minded, you know, similar thought processes, similar goals, similar motivation, similar drives. And we just met a couple hours ago, right? And right now, you know, we're talking about legacy. We're talking about culture. We're talking about entrepreneurship. We're talking about tech. We're talking about domination. And this is a small setting. Let's imagine if we were able to use our platform to quantify that times 5, times 10, times 100 with a collective resources, with collective thought process, with collective motivation, with collective, you know, ideas. The sky's the limit. So that's my answer to that question. I mean, I could talk all day about that. I mean, I love community. I love, you know, generational wealth, you know, legacy. I could talk about that stuff all day. So that's a short answer to it. But so yeah, Mike, go ahead.
Oh man, you said everything right there. If I could add anything, I just want to say that we just have to show up with excellence. I have a nonprofit called Detroit Possible, and what we understand that we have young people that need to see what they can become. We have to role model success to our young people and to those that are looking to grow so they can have a reference as to what they can become and what they can do. And I believe LiveWaves has an opportunity to be that conduit to where artists, entertainers, both unknown and known, can use this platform to role model success because they're not hindered, they're not limited, and they can do what they need to do. Our motto is your content, your rules. We need people to be courageous. We need people to have vision and have the forethought to use a platform that has everything they need just to use it and forget about mainstream thought or mm-hmm. Unprofitable loyalties, and now let's whatever the platform may be, let's use it to show excellence and the way that we need to go so that we can again change a thought process of a generation.
And a last thing, I have to put this in. I mean, not to get religious, but the Bible says that a man's gift will make room for him and bring him or her in front of many great people or kings, right? I believe that this platform has the ability to find those gifts, right? You know, that are seen and unseen, you know, to unlock it and to cultivate that gift, you know, to develop it, to build it. but furthermore, to expose it and spread those gifts, you know, that purpose, you know, that knowledge, that understanding, and put it anywhere in the world and say, hey, listen, you know, we're more than just, you know, what the media says that we are, right? You know, we're builders, you know, we're educators, you know, we're artists, you know, we're scientists, you know, we do nonprofit, you know, we can do anything. Oftentimes those gifts are untapped. You know, people don't have the resources. People don't have the, you know, the right platform. People don't have the right exposure. And so I believe, you know, with our platform and with us, you know, with our collective gifts and mindsets, that, you know, we can do many great things that's going to change generations to come.
Well, you know, it's really valuable in speaking to people like Master P and other major entertainers in the hip-hop industry. You know, when they took a look at Clubhouse, they loved it. They jumped on it first. But their thing was, man, we need something created by black folk like this. Why couldn't a black organization or a black person have created something as powerful and influential as Clubhouse? So to see, you know, with your app, you know, and your ability to, like you said, create something better than Facebook, better than Instagram, better than all of those other platforms, and then it's created by two powerful black men. I love that. I think the entertainment world will love that. As they break all these new apps and all these new technologies, everybody working through the entertainers and the celebrities to make them popular. But I think the entertainers and celebrities are ready and open for one that's created for us, by us, but at the same time can affect the whole world. So I'm excited tonight. I haven't seen the app. I'm taking your word on it. I haven't been on it. But, you know, just the very fact that, you know, you're bold enough to create it, I think we should be bold enough to help get behind and support Dr. Lee standing. Ladies and gentlemen, I think if they app can do what they say it can do, I think we all need to get behind it, get on it, and support it. And then if it can also benefit our products and our merchandising, then it's a win-win.
Yeah.
What we're looking for.
Yeah.
So I'm excited about this show, Dr.
I'm so glad that you are, and I really wanted you to. I know your schedule was really, really tight tonight. I appreciate your coming on. We're all in this here together. And our team members, you know, I'm so happy you're here. I always want you to know, I'm so transparent. I always tell people, I am very, very transparent. I want you to know what's going on. I'm not making any decisions alone. You know, I want us to, we're all in this together with collaborators. And as we move, you know, when I see something like this, I want you to hear it, that you can understand why I'm so excited. And you know, and fully, because where I go, you're going. We're all going together. And so I'm not one that, you know, just do things and make decisions, you know, without you knowing fully. So I'm so grateful that, you know, you're here. You're hearing what I've been speaking of. I mean, it's coming to fruition. We've been talking about this. We've been dreaming about it. And so it's happening now. And with Live Waves. And so let's get ready, y'all. And we're taking the world by storm, okay? Because we're literally everywhere. We've got Dr. Ken and I discovered that we've got almost 3%. It was like 2.7% of our listeners are out of China. And I'm like, okay, why are they listening to us? You know, I think that's a significant percentage, you know. So we are making impact. We were on the homepage, We made the homepage, which is, I don't know if this is the second time, I think, that we have made the homepage on Blog Talk. And so that's significant. And so I'm just happy that you're all here, that you heard firsthand from the team whom I have confidence in and 100% sold. And I believe that you are. And so I'm just happy tonight. And you all are excused from being fussed at tomorrow. And so you've made me very proud tonight, and we're moving forward, even though prayer and all the things that we do together are so needful, because you know I took that fall last week, two Saturdays ago, and not recovered, but you know it could have been a different story. Really could have been a different story today, because it was a hard fall and hit in my head. But everything was normal. You know, that was God. That's God. I'm going to be sore. I'm going to go through a few things, but I'm going to continue to get well. I'm surrounded with my medical staff and my psychological people. So we're going to be fine. So, again, I want to thank you all. And so we're going to, Dr. Cannon, I'm going to ask you to do your summary, and then we're going to get back into our lineup. I think the next one was Attorney Russell Smith. So, Dr. Cannon, just in case you need to go.
Beautiful. I appreciate it, y'all. You know, we started out doing these Blog Talk radio shows, you know, two, almost 3 years ago, been outstanding. We've been faithful every week. Dr. Lee's been faithful from the first show. But you know, y'all, since we started doing these shows, so much more technology has come to the table. I mean, from Zoom to where you could go live. When we started, you know, I mean, the technology to be able to go live has just only been 5-6 years where you could go live with video, where a Clubhouse could come in, and then our brothers come with a powerful new app. And, you know, we just got to be proactive as a people and be willing to jump in. You know, if we give you a show, many of y'all have been listening to shows week after week, but it's time for you to come forth with your ideals, to be creative, and to think out of the box. What type of show do you want? If you go live every week, do you have any merchandise? If we got an apparatus where you can put your merchandise up and it can be made available to millions of people week after week, thousands of people, hundreds of people week after week, will you be proactive enough to come with your merchandising? If we need you to host the show, can you be courageous enough, even if it's the first time, for you to go live and for you to host the show? If we give you a new app to use that's going to bring people to you and give you an opportunity to share your merchandising, to share your intellectual ideals, and we can capture your ideal. If we show you how to write a book on Amazon, where I've got 8 books up on Amazon, will you be proactive enough to get your book finished in 30 days? Or will you procrastinate and take another 3 years to finish something that you know you should already have up on Amazon selling? I ordered my books from Amazon on a Friday night. And to my house on Sunday morning. 2 days, even on a Sunday, they got the books to my house, y'all. We should be writing books. We should be designing merchandise, T-shirts, hats, around whatever your passion is, and putting it on the internet and pushing it and having fun with it. I'm having fun pushing my books over the internet, letting people know that they can get my book in 2 days. And I don't even have to package it. I don't have to send it in the mail. Amazon would do that. I'm simply saying we've got tools, y'all. And if we don't use these tools to get to the next level, then we're being negligent.
and not to be negligent, then we want to be proactive, y'all. And so I'm saying our brothers have brought us a powerful, powerful presentation tonight on a powerful show. And if you missed any of it, like I missed some of it, you have the ability to go back into Dr. Lee's archives and pull this show out and listen to it again and again and share with your family and so they can listen to it. You have the ability to slow it down and take notes so that we can do this thing and be effective, y'all. Like the brother said, this is the greatest time in history to be alive. Really, it is, y'all. Really, it is, y'all. Tools now that we can use that will help take us to a whole nother level. Dr. Lee, I appreciate you for being faithful on this show. I appreciate you, but we need to do even more. We need to get some merchandising on this show. We need to get some advertising on this show. 2 hours is great. Standing job.
I'm ready.
But take us to a whole nother level, then we want to jump on board. We want to synergize with them. We appreciate y'all tonight coming on the show.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Okay, Dr. Moncrief, I think you were next.
Thank you. And I appreciate tonight's show and the comments, and I wish these two young men much success. And I need when they give their comments for them to, again, tell us how to get in contact with them, getting on the ground floor. And I hope and I would suggest to them as they go forth and talk about their product, that they emphasize the difference between being a platform that people can come and place their what they want to do on versus, you know, being an app versus being a quote, a platform that's a voice in the community. Also, I would like to suggest to these young men, and they've probably done this already, but they look back into some of our Detroit Black history. Don Barton, for example, and his experience with, you know, with the Barton Cable Company, and how the Blacks in the city of Detroit got behind him, and he ended up selling, you know, the Black Cable Company to a white company, to Comcast.
Yeah.
Okay. And so as we talk about our history, our legacy, and generational wealth, you know, that, you know, we take a look at our history and see how, you know, business is business. But being Black, we have to kind of be bigger than business is business. And so, you know, just take a look at that. But I'm very excited about this robust platform that you presented. It's much, much bigger than any of these other companies that were mentioned tonight. I'm a little concerned about the part where you said, you know, you can't record our videos and da da da, because, you know, it's just like going to the movie. You know, somebody sitting out there with the camera recording your monitor. So, you know, the way you do all the sophisticated stuff behind the scenes to keep people from stealing, you know, the 17, 18-year-old has got their video camera out, taking pictures of the screen. So, again, I'm excited about your product, your platform, and I'm looking forward to getting information so that I can look into investing on something on the ground floor of a Black platform like yours. So good luck to you guys.
Thank you, Dr. Moncrief. Now, the concern regarding the video, we can record. I believe we can record our own and distribute our own. I think, and if you guys can, I can clarify by that even right now about the. I mean, we. How does that work? You all don't store it for various reasons, but we can capture it, or you can capture it for us and give it to us, and then we can do what we want to do with it, right?
Part one is definitely, Mike, you can chime in real quickly. I just want to say that you can definitely pre-record your content and also record your content as well. We're just saying that
record while we're live.
Mike, is that? Yeah, that's accurate, Mike. Michael.
So this is how it works. As of right now, we don't have storage for live streaming. However, there's been a number of content creators that said that they really need that that opportunity in the app. So we are revisiting that. So that may change in the near future. We're currently making some additions to the app right now to make it even more robust and dope. So again, we're going to satisfy the needs of our content creators because that's what the app is built for. Now, what we're doing, so what we recommend right now is you have two devices. One device you do your live streaming on because you know it can't be recorded. The second device you do your recording so that you now mm-hmm. have access to both engagements for your content.
Mm-hmm. Right. And that's what we'll be doing, team. That's what we'll be doing. We will be doing both with their help. And we'll have ours. So you all don't have to worry about that. Attorney Russell Smith.
Okay, yeah. I agree with everyone, this sounds like a great product. I did take a look at the webpage here for Wyrd. You guys are distinct from Wyrd, or I see one of you guys on the page, but... So I just want to make sure, as was requested, that you guys give us your contact information as well. And I'll definitely be trying to reach out to you myself.
Okay.
Okay, you can give your contact information and clarify the question regarding the one, or you say one, the partnership of Wyrd. Who is behind Wyrd? Wyrd.
Great. So Michael Dorsey is a part of Wyrd Ventures. Wyrd Ventures owns LiveWaves. So when you look at the website on Wyrd, you saw myself, Dominique McMullen, is an employee of LiveWaves. He's part owner, and he has a position in LiveWaves.
Okay.
So I am.
I saw Mr. Dorsey, but I didn't see you. I'm just looking at the content. You know, the was it about section here? So is are you under mobile app developments or? Anyway, it doesn't matter.
Yes.
I mean, I'll look through there when we get a chance. I just want to make sure I know how to contact you, and you know, since this is located elsewhere than Detroit, so okay.
And you can always remember, all of you, that you can always contact one another through our show, or you all have our contact information, and we will connect you with anyone you want to be connected to. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Attorney Russell.
Okay, no problem.
Dr. Long.
Again, thank you for the invite, Dr. Lee. Honestly, when the show began, I didn't know what to expect. I'm not a high-tech individual. But of course, you know, that's where everything is right now. So, very informative, and I'm happy, most happy that I was able to get a colleague of mine on the phone and to show his interest, Russ Smith, Attorney Russ Smith, because we do have a lot of content from our nonprofit, and it's just sitting there because we didn't know what to really do with it. Like I mentioned earlier, we engaged a gentleman who previously owned Heart and Soul magazine and turned that magazine into a website called blackdoctor.com. But we, like I said, the content we had that we thought that we could provide to him, it just never moved. So this was a very informative show. I look forward to engaging you guys in the near future, and again, wish you both much success. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Long. Brenda, if you're still here, you're certainly welcome to give some final thoughts. Brenda? Brenda? Okay. So, gentlemen, you can wrap us up tonight in your own way.
I go first. I just want to say I definitely didn't expect all this at one time. I'm definitely grateful for you guys' interest and in your time and all your questions, and I'm just excited about how this thing is going to go forward in a major way. I want to give a shout out to Ms. Sparkle, Francesca. She introduced me to Dr. Mary. So definitely want to give her a shout out if she's listening. God bless you, and I thank you for this, for introducing me initially. And I'm just excited. I think I've been talking for a long time now. I need some water. So, for real, I'm sweating over here and everything. So I'm hot, So, but yeah, I'm just excited. And more so, I'm really excited because of all the great minds just on the line at the same time. All the elders, all the doctors, the pastors, that means a lot to me. That you all took a part of your day, a part of your time to listen intently. It's been times where I've been in rooms, speaking with people who do venture capital, right? And I walk in the room, and I might be the only African American in the room, but I have the best product, right? So it's been, some challenges, ups and downs, but I think that, we found a partnership that's going to be lucrative and beneficial in many ways. I don't know what else to say. I'm thirsty, so I'm going to get some water now, like Mike finishes us off. Oh, but also I can be reached at my number is 313-400-0290. That's my personal cell phone number. That's 313-400-0290. My email is dmcmullen531@gmail.com. That's my personal Gmail. IG is YBRNIQ. That's YBRNIQE. That's my personal IG. So my Facebook is Dom McMullen. So if you want to give me an email, a call, a Facebook inbox, IG inbox, just let me know and we can talk it up and talk and go from there. Okay, Mike, I'm done. God bless all y'all. I'm looking forward to it. Let's do it. Let's make history. Let's hit home runs. Let's do it all. I'm ready. So okay, go ahead, Mike. I'm done.
Well, I am humble. By the love that you guys have shown. I'm so very appreciative of this time. And don't think we take this lightly. You'll find that we are very serious people. We are very focused. We are intentional. And we are, we've been built and we've been through enough to handle what lies ahead. And we've put together a dynamic team of people that I'm sure you're going to meet on one day, minds from all over the country, black minds that are very accomplished and have resumes longer than mine. But this collective of people, we believe, has been preordained and destined to make a difference and do something that has never been done before. And we need your help to do it. We need you guys to check that. Get on the app. Tell somebody. If you have influence, if you have people that can use the app, just simply let them know about it and let them make the decision. Because we're confident that anyone that uses this app and has content will love it, and they will use it, and they will be the better for it. If you want to continue engagement, I can be reached. My phone number is 248-242-2222. 2766. My email address is mdorsey@lwmail.app. And, of course, I have all the social media handles. You just look at Michael Dorsey. But I can't wait till you meet the rest of our team. Our CBO is a brilliant guy. He's a pastor. I'm an elder. Our CFO is brilliant. We have so many great people associated with our team and collective that I think pound for pound we can match up with any other group of executives on these apps. And I think we're going to show in time that we were supposed to be here, and with your help, we will get there. Thank you guys so much, and I'll see you later.
Absolutely, absolutely. We're so thankful. We appreciate you. And what we're going to say to the Breakfast Club is y'all better get on over. And we thank y'all, and I appreciate all of you. Thank you for listening. Our listening audience, all of our team members, our family, you know, we're all family, and we just appreciate you, and we're moving forward. We're on board. They have no idea what's getting ready to happen. So I love you, and we're here, and we're in this here together. Thank you all. God bless. Stay safe. This is Dr. Mary Lee. Until next week, same time, same place. God bless. Good night.
Night.
Peace to the ancestors.
Good night.
Yes. Peace to
God.
Good night.
Cornel
West. Yes. Peace to the movement. Yes. We came from the bottom. Ever since they got us, we've been going through these problems. 400 years behind, and it's no promise that we gon' never actually be equal, to be honest. It's messed up how they put us in chains. They kidnapped our language and changed our names. But when we speak Ebonics, then they call it a shame. They leave us with a couple options, rob or slang. Now we locked up a game. How much can our skin take? We went from slaves to inmates, carrying the weight of the 50 states, working your farms. Black nannies carrying white babies in their arms. Black men sacrifice their lives in your wars. But you'll never show appreciation here at home. You treat us so damn wrong. You act like you hate my race. The police, they just beat us in the streets like an 808 base. America, when will you defend my case? It never will, cause your freedom is fake. I'm only living here cause I'm one to get paid enough to round up all my family and shake.
Get up, get up, get up, get up, get up, get up.
Couple of quirks, can't call it pancakes cause you pour some syrup. It's a whole lot bigger than a pretty new house, especially when the rodent's still running about. P. Diddy running marathons, races go. That's going to the school where the tax money go. Homeland security, now there's a phenomenon. Pacifying folks by hanging Saddam. Truth still riding, still obliging, still no Bin Laden. Tuned in waiting for the president's announcements. No 40 acres. Take these 40 ounces. We ain't gonna get on the levees. Revolution televised early. Is you ready?
Why you wanna treat me so cold? America.
Lost your mind, especially when you done been down for so much time. Getting up don't even really ever cross your mind. You got porn shop, gun shop, liquor store sign. SWAT team, crack fiend, unemployed line. Stay late, dollar short, trying to buy time. What we do to survive is defined as a life of crime. You can't ball, then you force the grind. If you fall, then you cross the line. And I've been putting in work from 9 to 5 and 5 to 9. Since phone calls cost a dime. What it made me is one of the relevant, highly intelligent brothers not only dealing with the same drugs. If I'm a hustler, then what's more American? We all founded on the same thug heritage.
Why you wanna treat me?